Saad Saab, KEENU is, mashallah, a big name. So I'll repeat my same question that I asked from Awais Saab. What do you actually see the role of fintechs? Is it a mushroom growth? And as compared to the number of fintechs that we have in Pakistan, there is not much of a contribution towards the cause, or they are playing an effective role? And if there is some gaps, there is some loophole, what are those?
Thank you for allowing me the chance to express myself. I think to start with, I would like to answer one more thing that you asked from Awais Bhai. That was EMI and the limits and all. You see, being a fintech ourselves and starting at a time when people had not heard of this terminology in Pakistan, especially six and a half years ago. So at that time, we were called third parties, and we were not given the kind of respect that we get.
Third parties was the name.
We called third party service providers, right?
Right.
We used to, you know, feel bad about it, ashamed about it, but we kept on going. And we thought, you know, someday, sometime, people will understand what we contribute. So thing is, as far as EMI is concerned, my and my company's belief is that it's going to be, for this industry, what Renaissance was for Europe, right? You will see its benefits being reaped. It's just happened. We, as a country, as an industry, are still getting accustomed to what EMIs are. Plus, as EMIs enter and they get their approvals, they work with on different use cases, trying to get supremacy over another. So healthy competition will come into play, and then you will see the marvel of this regulation. As far as I'm concerned, I believe we are still in a very nascent stage. It's too early to judge whether there is a the market has become too overcrowded, or there's a lot of scope in the market. So it's too early right now. I believe what is required is support for the financial technology companies. In the West, where you see a plethora of such companies making inroads and making a mark in the overall economy, they initially, at the initial times, get a lot of support, free office space, tax benefits. I believe that is the way to go about it. State Bank probably, I believe, has done quite a bit. They have done their bit, and as far as limits are concerned, I'm sure they've been, I mean, for branchless banking, they've been very vocal, and also they've been very receptive. So limits should not be a problem, will not be a problem. I believe the government part is still missing. You would see sustainable fintech growth when government comes in. You give chance to youngsters. KEENU is one of the lucky entities. We are probably one out of the 50 who are standing here and who are processing 6 billion worth of transactions every month and growing. But nobody's, I think we did work hard, but we were lucky at the same time. So that is one part. Secondly, I believe what fintechs, the mistake that we do, we don't think local. Localization is of the essence. See, there is no international solution to a local problem. You have always got to think local. When you start, you have to be ultra lean. For example, me as a chief operating officer, I may start thinking myself as a yuppie who should have the best car in the country. You should have, you know, the biggest paycheck. कहते ना कुर्बानी कुर्बानी देनी पड़ती है सही मानों में हर तरह से
Very
तो
good.
आपको बहुत एक्सपेंस कंट्रोल बिकॉज ये एनवायरमेंट फर्क है मे बी इन यूएसए आप स्टार्ट करें तो यू स्टार्ट बिग ताकि लोग आपको देखें पहला काम पाकिस्तान में जो हमने सीखा वो ये है कि आप सस्टेनेबल ग्रोथ करें कीप योर आई एट द टारगेट बट बी वेरी रियलिस्टिक एंड लीन एट द सेम टाइम और हर बंदे को अपना रोल अदा करना होता है दैट इज वाई फिनटेक्स can do what a bank can't do. It's the structural, is a leaner structure that a fintech has. So that is, those are my two cents.
So we really wish and hope that the fintechs really need that desired stage that our industry deserves.
I don't have any doubt whatsoever. It will happen. Just give it a bit more time. I'll just give you a timeline. Maybe we'll be sitting here after 2 years and you'll be saying, how can you stop fintechs from taking over certain entities, business. maybe we'll discuss that because you will see phenomenal growth.
Talking about the different avenues of digitization, QR code is one of them, right? But we have seen a very modest growth in this QR codes. What could be the reason of this? I mean, recently, 6 months back, I was in a seminar in Philippines, and they had given us an app for that event. And all of the information of all the attendees was within that app. And you know, we were not actually exchanging the cards. We were saying, did I scan you? So hum log ek dusre ko scan kar rahe the instead of exchanging the cards. But ye jo QR codes ke hawale se growth and progress, that has been very modest. What would be the reason of this?
Sir, part of what I said earlier, I'm going to repeat, and then I'm going to just give my two cents on QRs as well. You see, again, I would say, number one, there's not much time that has been spent on QRs, right? It will not spread like wildfire. Nothing does. When you read case studies, it gives you the impression that somebody came and saw and conquered. You know, it doesn't work that way. There's a lot of work on the back of it. So giving credit to entities who have laid down QR code based networks, I think they have done a lot of hard work. They must have learned a lot. My friend over here, they're one of the people who innovated in this way. They might have done a few mistakes, which they only know because they were the innovators and leaders. And they will come back, they'll bounce back. So that's one part. Number two, not only relating to QR, I believe in anything that we do, Pakistanis have, including ourselves, we have been a bit more hasty, right? We haven't taken a step back and analyzed that, you know, is this the idea whose time has come in this country? I believe still QR will pick up when people are ready. You see, the issuing part is more important right now.
True.
I'll give you a real life example. You see, 7 years ago, and few of my colleagues are sitting over here who were with me when we were founding KEENU. So the industry volume in 2012 was what we alone are processing right now. That was just 6.5 years ago. So what tells you? I mean, what the statement tells you? This statement tells you that, you see, people were not accustomed of using plastic. I was once a product manager in Fessel Bank, and we used to struggle in communicating this to people that, you know, it is not going to be a problem. Just give your card to the merchant, he will swipe it, you will get discounts. We were the first ones to give discounts on debit cards because we did not know how to, you know, promote it to people. Then suddenly the time 2012 came, and luckily we were thinking of forming a network. That is when the double digit growth started. Now we are sitting at 330 billion a year of plastic volume. It may seem to be very low, but just imagine where we came from.
True, very right. So the journey is important.
The idea whose time has come. So I believe smartphones are still not that widely used. Data is cheap in Pakistan, but it's still not very widely used. Probably they are not the two reasons. Probably the other reason is the user interface, the lack of localization. But we have to go through a curve.
Pakistan, lovely. So that means QR codes, the time will come.
There is a potential. But
there is a potential.
Right.
All right.